Hi, my name is Edgar, and I'm a front-end engineer on the marketing team at Glide. Glide helps you build powerful software for your business. And today, I'm going to be sharing how we used the new features of the App Router to build our blazing fast documentation. Enjoy. The first thing I want to talk about is the OG image by Next.js. And when you use the App Router, it's native to you and you can find it in Next server. Right. So the way we've used this is we've used it to create dynamic OG images for all of our pages. The way we did this before was with a tool that was sometimes down and not everyone had access, so you needed to know the right person to ping if an issue came up. These didn't happen frequently, but at least now we have everything in the same code base and it's much easier to make changes. Let's see how we use it here. So the first things that we do is we're using the new format for API routes. So the way that looks, that's different from the pages folder is you have an API folder. And then you have the name of the API route, and then you have a route file. And then for get requests, the name of the function you're going to export is get for post, delete, etc. as we go. So the first thing we're doing is we're pulling three search parameters for title, description, and section. So the title is the first part here. The description shows up here, and we're using section to create different backgrounds, as we can see here. So I'm just going to open another one, and we're going to see this is in a different section, so it has a different background. If you look at the URL, this is in the Essentials section. And if I just switch to this tab, this is in the Getting Started section. So I'll just talk about some of the other things we're doing here. We're pulling the enter font, which is the fonts that we're using here, which is really great. We're able to use custom fonts in this file. And then the way it's returned in the documentation is return new image response, which I mentioned. We pull directly from Next server instead of importing the whole package just in case you were using the pages folder. And then this is where we have background. And if I just open that quickly, these are the different sections that we have. And these are just SVG files that are rendering these pages. And then we have other colors that we use to color the text. I'll just head back here. And another thing that is great about this section is we have the TW prop, which lets us use Tailwind classes even in this file, which is also a benefit that helps us use the same CSS that we're using in the code base to render our OG images. And then the last thing that we have to do is set props for width, heights, any custom fonts that are being loaded, and the weight of the fonts, their style, and the name. Yeah, I'll move on to the next section. Thing is the new metadata type that's exported from Next. So previously, we did this ourselves. We passed in title, description, open graph, and all the other meta tags that we used. But now this is strongly typed and Next just tells us which ones to use, and it generates for Open Graph, for example, it generates for Twitter, Facebook, and a couple of other platforms that we're going to need to check the documentation for. But this is for a basic page, and it's not what we want to show right now. So if we go to our dynamic pages, which powers up all the other kinds of pages in our documentation, we're going to see that we return this as a promise instead of just the way we use it here. And then we have a new function called generate metadata, which is native to Next.js app router. And then we pull in the fields that we need and their types. And then we can do things like title, description, open graph, And if you look at this section for 1 second, you'll notice what we spoke about in the previous section where we had dynamic OG images. So these are just passing the fields from the previous section. So the title, the description, and the section, and that gets rendered on the fly at build time. And we're also passing alternates for canonical tags. So this is one advantage of having this strongly typed, is that you just pull up the fields for meta tags and you type them in. And if for some reason you can't find one that you're looking for, you can head to the type and actually read it. So that was how we found the canonical tag, for example, just a quick search, and you will be able to find where this goes. Great, so let's hop on to the next section. All right, so our next favorite thing is how we fetch data into pages. And we're using a server component here, which is a new feature by the React team that Next.js has implemented in the app router, just in case you weren't aware of that. And in this top level page, we see that we're using a try catch, and then we fetch the data from an internal API page, which is this one. And then that data, we massage the data into what we want to have, and then we pass it back to the client. So these are the fields that we want that generate the page, and then we throw an error just in case one occurs. And then we come back to that page, and then we do another try catch. So if the request is successful, it's going to pass all the data to this page. And if it's not successful, it's going to throw a not found function. It's going to call a not found function, and this function renders a 404 page. Another great thing about this is how we have preview mode here. And it's easier to spin up preview mode for the content team because of the new features. And if it's in preview mode, the content team can see the latest changes that we have made in Contentful, which is our CMS of choice, and get internal feedback, implement the changes that were requested before we publish new pages. This has sped up our productivity tremendously. The content team loves it. I don't need to get pulled in anytime changes are made. Feedback is gotten the correct way, and then we publish. It's just helped us have a very solid ideation to publish workflow. And these are the API routes that handle this. So we have a GET request, and then we grab some parameters from the URL, which is our secret from Contentful, and the ID of the page that's being generated. If the secret is wrong or the page doesn't exist, we throw an error. And if it's correct, we grab the preview version of the page, and then we redirect back to the page and render the content. All right, so we've come to the end of the talk, and I hope you enjoyed it just as much as I enjoyed making it for you. I'm super excited for the rest of the announcements today and the rest of the talks. I hope you have a great day. I'm going to leave my Twitter on the screen just in case you want to connect. Feel free to reach out. Ciao.